HarperCollins presents It's Fine, It's Fine, It's Fine, It's Not by Taz Alam. Read by Taz Alam. My note to you. Growing up, I struggled with a lot of difficult emotions. I never felt like I had anyone to talk to about the things I was going through, which led me to feel isolated and alone. That is why I wanted to write this poetry book. I wanted to talk about things I wish I was able to hear when I was younger that might have helped me growing up. This book is honest and real. It will make you feel seen and understood. More importantly, it will assure you that what you're feeling is normal, valid, and okay. Life can be joyous and empowering, but also difficult and confusing at times. Let's talk openly about how we feel and navigate life's challenges together. How to use this audiobook. This book is a safe space for you to feel whatever you're feeling without judgment. There will be moments of joy, love, and purpose, but there will also be moments where the journey is tough and it feels a little too real. Life can get a little too much at times. I understand, but know that you don't have to go through it alone. Let this audiobook be your comfort to help you process the emotions that come with life. If you're feeling in need of uplift, a hug, or a friend, the chapters Healing and I'm Fine are a great place to start. There are poems that touch on sensitive topics that may be triggering. The chapter It's Not Fine deals with some tough topics that can be difficult to process. That's okay. It's important to always take care of yourself. Whether you're feeling lost, confused, scared, struggling with relationships, this book will help you feel seen, validated, and understood. Feel free to come here whenever you want comfort and a safe space to process your emotions. Life can be difficult to navigate, so let's work through it together. Who am I? Self-love, questioning myself, body image. Who am I? Sometimes I question what I'm doing with my life. Am I happy? Am I content? Or am I living a life I didn't ask for and will one day look back on and resent? It's funny, isn't it? Life demands so much from you, but rarely ever asks your consent. From birth, you're trained to think a certain way. From how you dress, your education, to things you say, it's all conditioned. It's been ingrained. But then you grow up and start to think for yourself. And suddenly you look around and no one's there to help. You start to question things about your life. Slowly, things start to change. You have these innate desires and thoughts you can't always explain. You no longer align with the plan set out for you, and for some reason that makes you feel strange. You're filled with so much guilt just for thinking a different way. But you can't deny, deep down inside, something just doesn't feel right. And sadly, we grow up. Life takes over, and we give up the fight. We do as we're told, give in to society, and eventually, the light inside us dies. This almost seems inevitable at this point. We've seen it happen too many times. I struggled with this feeling a lot, constantly battling with myself, doing everything society wanted from me till it affected my mental health. We give so much of ourselves away only for people to judge. We sacrifice our souls and wonder why we never feel good enough. Imagine instead of trying so hard to fit in, we focused on self-love. Maybe then we wouldn't be so quick to give up. I can't fight this feeling anymore. I can't repress the person in me screaming to be let out. Everyone settles and accepts this way of life, but the silence is too loud. I want to escape. I want to run. I want to drown the noise and shout. I want to live. I want to know what life's truly about. I want to rediscover myself, create the person I'm meant to be, decondition everything I've been taught to finally feel free. We only get one chance at life. We owe it to ourselves to at least try. Yeah, we could sink and fail, but maybe. Just maybe, we can fly. Am I scared? Am I scared? Absolutely terrified, but not as scared as living and never feeling alive. Charades. I spent my whole life playing roles, changing myself to suit other people's needs. I learned that is how you survive in this world. If you want to get somewhere in life, then you need to people please. At times, life feels like a game of charades. I wake up and think, what character will I play today? I question if I'm even living for myself. Is this really what I would think and say? It's strange. I can so easily adapt and change. But one person I've never known is myself. Who even am I at this stage? Why do we choose to hate ourselves? Why do we refuse to give ourselves love, but are so adamant on bringing ourselves down? Why is it that between love and hate, the latter always takes the crown? Why are we so comfortable seeing our own downfall? Why are we so afraid to be kind to ourselves? We're so consumed by these unrealistic standards that we'd rather prioritize other people's opinions than our own mental health. But what if we dared to be rebellious? What if we stood up and were brave? We finally decided to love ourselves. I wonder how much our lives would change. I want to shower myself with abundant love. I want to relish denial for a while. I want to see life from a different perspective, take on life with a smile. Hating myself is exhausting. I want to know what it feels like to matter. Between hate and happiness, I want to choose the latter. It's complicated. Humans are complicated, yet we package ourselves in a perfect way to make it easy for people to digest, to make them feel comfortable. We put on our daily mask, remove ourselves of flaws and anything remotely vulnerable. Why is society fascinated with perfection when humans are inherently complicated? Why do we feel the need to hide our imperfections almost as if we're obligated? We're an amalgamation of our experiences, environment, behaviors instilled in us from a young age. All of this happens before we even start to think for ourselves. We spend our adult lives living with a version of ourselves we had little choice in creating and navigating life with little to no help. As we become self-aware, we start to hate ourselves for the way we think, the things we do, the way we behave. The emotions become overwhelming and we're filled with guilt and shame. The anger inside builds and the frustration gets harder to tame. For anyone who can relate, I need you to know that you're not to blame. Some of us spend our whole adult lives unlearning what we were taught, but it's tough. We try to repress our ugly, repress our broken, but some days the work doesn't feel enough. You become guarded with your space when really you're just protecting, or become so overwhelmed with the emotions that you resort to projecting. It sucks because you never asked to be this way. You never asked for any of it. Yet you've been left to fix the pain. Some bad memories linger like cheap perfume. And no matter how much you try to restrain, every now and again, they escape. They come out screaming and reveal themselves in the most raw and darkest ways, to serve as a harsh reminder that you can never truly get away. This is something you have to live with, and the pain is here to stay. Why? Why do we tear ourselves apart trying to please people who have never once tried to listen or take the time to understand us? Compare myself. I know I shouldn't compare, but when I scroll through social media, I can't help but stop and stare. Looking at all the perfect lives on my screen, feeling like life is unfair. And I keep feeding this unhealthy habit until I can no longer bear. I know it's no good for me. yet I continue to seek it out and then beat myself up. It's a losing game that I'm addicted to, an unhealthy obsession, and I can't get enough. Everyone seems so ahead in life. People who are younger than me are more successful. It's like I'm so behind in life that I'm constantly playing catch-up, and living has become so incredibly stressful. I want to hide from the world. I feel like a constant failure. And I know this isn't a healthy way to cope, but I don't know how to correct this behavior. I hate myself. I hate myself. I hate my face. I hate my body. I hate the environment that I'm in. I'm filled with so much hate, I don't know what to do with all of it. I look at models in magazines, and when I look back at myself, I no longer like what I see. They don't show you the stretch marks, split ends, gap teeth. They don't represent people like you and me. Isn't it ironic how we're forced messages like be yourself by manufactured celebrities when they know they're partially to blame for all our insecurities? If we do this, say that, and wear this, then a guy might just like me. I can't hold a conversation without saying the word sorry like 15 gazillion times to say that I'm apologizing for just being me. Some days the silence is so loud it keeps me up at night. I can't sleep or eat. Filled with so much negativity until negativity became me. But I lie and carry on smiling because that's the person I want to be. So happy, joyful, and carefree. People say, just be confident. They don't understand that you get tired. You get weak. I just need you to see that I'm filled with self-hate and it consumes me. Because I wasn't brought up to be proud of myself and love who I am. No, I was told there were expectations and limitations and fought for every can't to be a can. So filled with hate, I suffocate. This is my fate. I tell myself as I try to pick myself up, but it's too late. I don't want compliments or attention from passers-by. I crave real love, not likes. You know, you start to create this self-image that is so perfect, so flawless, so happy, because you think that's what is right. Wrong. See, you can't fill a void with lies. You can't resolve pain with short highs. So you resort to late-night cries and you wonder why. For the longest time, I would blame my environment, the media, my peers. And it took me years to see that it's not you, it's me. If I want to change how I feel, I have to start from within. Look into my soul, what's beneath the skin? You can't solve your problems from scrolling on your phone. The answer comes from who you are deep inside. All those thoughts and feelings you tried so desperately to hide. I am capable of so much more, and I don't need to hear that from you because I know it for me. See, when you open your mind, you start to see things clearly, your potential, ambitions, and dreams. You become free. So for the first time in a long time, I'm just going to let myself breathe. Today, I choose me. I'm ugly. You keep telling yourself that you're ugly, how you can't possibly love yourself because every time you look in the mirror, you don't like what you see. The stretch marks, loose skin, gap between your front teeth, overanalyzing every single part of yourself, battering your self-esteem. Constantly telling yourself how could anyone ever want you, when even you don't like your own body. I wish I could make you understand that you're perfect, just by being you. And I tell you that every single day until you start to believe it too. And I mean it. I just wish you knew how much I adore you. How I love that even when you're going through some of your toughest times, you still put all of your energy into putting on a smile and acting like everything's fine. Or how I think you're brave, intelligent, gentle, kind. How you're going to change the world someday with that incredible mind. I hate seeing you cry, because when you look in the mirror, you see something you don't like. And I hate how much it hurts you every single time. I wish I could just take your pain away, make you see what I see, and then maybe you change your mind.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.